Hi, I'm Amit Prasad, founder of SatNav Group. If you feel the never-ending talk around workplace stress and fear post-pandemic due to return to office is misplaced, your next few minutes here will be well worth it. We've all gone through very challenging times these last couple of years. Events that have earlier happened only once in a century flashed right before our eyes. In our own lifetime, the pandemic has caused serious damage to many people's life, personally and professionally, some temporary and some permanent. However, it's wrong to think that work from home is the new normal. Why are we so focused on only a few vertical industries? Over 90% of Indian workforce across industries always worked throughout the pandemic, except during the government-mandated lockdown. Now, with most people getting vaccinated, those few employers are finally biting the bullet and asking their employees to return back to the office. While returning to work is a great relief for some, we keep hearing that many are stressed, there is anxiety, they worry about getting sick at the workplace. So as business leaders, we have to gain employees' trust by ensuring their physical and mental well-being. Please continue watching this video to know the best recommendations on managing workplace stress and fear post-pandemic as your employees return to work again. My suggestion to HR, facilities and admin managers is to manage workplace stress and fear in the post-pandemic return to work scenario is by fighting the ill-conceived notions of personal safety being at risk by coming to office. Footfalls in malls, pubs, cinema halls, attendance in public functions like marriages and celebrations are all going on unabated. So why is office the only risk? No doubt, the risk is always there and we should never downplay or underestimate it. But we just need to balance the risks that we face in life of all kinds of risks daily while walking on the road, while driving a car, even from those educated illiterate who spit on the road every few minutes as they are driving their vehicles. That also is a big health hazard. I believe any organization's top priority should be its employees, creating a safe and comfortable work environment for them, and no management shirks from it. So let's just take this care and compassion to the next level by increasing hygiene awareness among staff, the need to continue wearing masks when in close proximity of those that you don't know the background of, the need to cover your face when you cough, to never spit, to avoid shaking hands when you have an allergy, infection or a cold. In my opinion, these are more important than addressing vague concerns around safety. In parallel to the above, take the help of QuickFMS Return to Work Solutions, a product that we offer. Improving workplace safety and implementing space management ideas like maintaining higher physical distance between workstations, ensuring remote hot desk booking by smart workforce, doing rostering so you stagger timings and work days of your employees so that there's no crowding, and many other features. Our software will thus do its own bit to manage stress, to manage the fear when people are coming back to work and make them more comfortable. When most of the workforce managed to keep working during pandemic, so can the remaining who are still working from home. We all have a responsibility to ensure that our company's vision, mission is achieved. We grow efficiently without compromising on customer service levels. Let's get back to the efficiency levels before pandemic. Re-implement the learning process from peers and colleagues. Restart coaching and mentoring through physical interaction. I sincerely hope the misconception that is being propagated that work from home is better for company and employee as both are saving time and money is short-lived and we go back to well-established and proven ways of doing business, because that's the big need of the hour. I urge you to share this video with your personal and professional circles, especially amongst the management teams of global corporations with large offices in India, the captive back-end centers of Fortune 500 companies, the IT and BP industry folks across the country, or anyone else who's still trying to avoid going back to office. And I hope that my suggestions related to the increased focus on hygiene, as well as spreading awareness to make employees comfortable, will balance the risk-reward ratio. We all keep safe and also keep the kitchen fires burning in our homes. That's the right balance, and that's the safety and comfort that we should target. Thank you.